20,000 Chinese children are kidnapped every year. Their purpose? To feed a voracious baby trafficking industry that thrives on high demand and huge rewards. If you want to adopt a Chinese baby, someone, somewhere, can make that happen.
有了这种地下市场的需求呢，犯罪这个集团一般会什么？根据你的要求，去物色这种孩子，然后呢，采取一种什么？有的是拐骗，有的是什么？绑架。
Doctors, officials, orphanages, and even the man on the street are looking for a piece of the action.
也不是我一个人嘛，很多人嘛，把那个也都问走了，但是个这样。Leaving
helpless parents to wonder, how has this happened? Who's behind it? And can anyone stop it? 'Fastest developing countries in the world. An almost completely reformed economy has lifted millions of Chinese out of poverty. But such rapid change has also opened the door to a new world of criminal opportunity. Trading Chinese babies is one of them. Thousands of Americans want to adopt a Chinese baby, but the country doesn't have enough orphans. So a supply chain has sprung up to provide babies by any means possible.
那么有了这种地下市场的需求呢，犯罪这个集团一般会什么？根据你的要求，去物色这种孩子，然后呢，采取一种什么？有的是拐骗，有的是什么？绑架。这个很像什么？很像贩毒。Wang
Xu is a lawyer based in Hunan Province. His firm has dealt with cases related to missing babies.
根据市场的需求呢，我去进货。进了货以后呢，有人在各个环节上来什么负责转运，有的呢负责开一个小小的这个家庭的这个托儿所，把这些拐来的孩子放在这里养着。Today,
Duan Zilin is a sales assistant in a supermarket. She lives a quiet life, taking care of her children. But she was once a part of the baby trafficking chain. Acting together with her family as a supplier of over 100 babies to orphanages. It started in 2001 when Duan's mother received an interesting proposition from an orphanage she had been volunteering at.
带个小孩以后，就是说他们福利院那些院长啊要求啊，就是说他说，哎，你有的饭你就帮我捡过来，或者是说我可以给你工钱，也可以给你带一点。The
request was not unreasonable. Because of China's one-child policy, thousands of baby girls were being abandoned by couples desperate for a boy.
因为别人有儿子，你没有，中国人是吧？第一，对不起祖宗；第二呢，被别人看不起。Faced
with a surplus of unwanted girls, China opened its doors to international adoptions in 1992. They soon proved popular among Americans as the adoption process was thought to be easier and faster than it was back home. With high demand for Chinese babies, orphanages started paying people like Duan and her family to acquire them. No questions asked.
为什么就是说承担后果的就是我们？我觉得这点不应该，知道吧？Duan's
family started buying infants from a supplier in Wuchang City in Guangdong Province, 600 miles away. Up to 40 babies were available to them at any one time. The supplier claimed they had been abandoned. Duan didn't ask too many questions.
当我第一眼进他们家的时候，他们家就是说，好像一个棚子搭在那里，好多那个衣服堆的好多，一铺好长好长的床，就摆了八九个。当时我们也傻眼了，真的，那个时候我真的我也自己感觉，哎呦，怎么这么多吗？ 就是当时在那里挑个一个稍微漂亮点的，看到肩上穿的就把它抱回来吧。
For Duan and her family, this was a gold mine. For the first baby girl they delivered to the orphanage, they were paid over $350, more than the average monthly salary for an engineer at the time. The orphanage, however, considered this a good deal.
而且涉外收养渠道的话，它是通过所谓程序上是合法的手段，来把这个小朋友送入国外，被外国家庭领养。所以现在很多在福利院里面的涉外收养渠道，涉外收养渠道的话，福利院其实可以收取很高额的那个收养金。
Over 5 years, Duan and her family sold more than 100 babies. Massive profits were made all along the supply chain. Their supplier made $10,000, enough to send her son to college and pay the family's medical bills. But the situation was getting out of hand. Demand was so high and prices so outrageous that abducted children started appearing on the market.
现在很多被拐卖的儿童，可能更多的是农村的小朋友，可能或者是在城市里面打工，到城市里面打工带着小朋友，他可能是因为他大人看管不严。
The problem was becoming severe enough for the government to take notice. Duan and others like her were about to find their businesses attracting unwanted attention.In 1992, China legalized international adoptions, allowing Chinese babies to find homes outside the country. But the policy became too successful, with Americans paying $30,000 in administrative fees per child. A baby trafficking industry has sprung up, supplying not just abandoned, but abducted children as well. Official reports estimate that 20,000 Chinese children are kidnapped every year for adoption. The country's strict family planning laws could, in fact, be creating opportunity for kidnappers. Before a woman gives birth, she and her family must apply for a birth permit. Officials run a variety of checks, for example, on whether the couple is married. The process can take up to 3 years. Unsurprisingly,Many women bypass the system.
因为我们国家实行这个户籍管理制度，而且是生育许可制度，任何一个在医院要去生孩子的人，如果没有这个准生证的话，他就不能生。这个，所以你只要生孩子进医院，没有准生证，那当然就知道了。所以就会出现一些在家庭接生啊，在非法的小医院接生出现的惨剧嘛。
Illegal clinics lack safeguards and security.Making it easier for traffickers to snatch the baby. But even those who opt for the legal route are at risk. In August 2013, the deputy director of Fuping County Maternity Hospital, Zhang Xuxia, was detained on suspicion of human trafficking. Zhang, an obstetrician, allegedly convinced numerous parents to give up their babies, stating that the babies had serious health conditions.She would stop parents from seeing them and convince parents to give them up. Investigators knew that it had to be an inside job.
按照正常的，就是讲，规章制度，他医院的他的那个妇产，他有一系列的规章制度，那么就是讲，只要按照规章制度，任何人不可能把这个婴儿抱走。如果没有的话，按照常规来讲。那么就是讲，就是他们就是人情关系，就是讲睁只眼闭只眼啊，你是医生，你讲的算，我有些个规章制度，只要不违反这个医院里的更大的这个规章制度或者是投放法律的情况下，就是讲睁只眼闭只眼，就是亲情关系，所以讲在很多方面是制度就丧失了他的应有的。
Following an investigation, three government officials and three senior management staff of the hospital were sacked in connection to the scandal. Zhang Xuxia was sentenced to death. Babies from such scams would end up in the hands of traffickers, who would then sell them to orphanages. One such trafficker was Duan Zilin.
一 般的话，我们抱来的都是生下来刚刚大概一个礼拜啊左右的，就是有的时候那个齿带都没断的，因为都是人家不要的扔出来了，就是一生下来就把它扔出来了呀。应该就是说这么大的时候它都有那个免疫力吧，应该是应该不会有任何问题，这吃得好睡得好就差不多。一般我也反正在我手上反正没有过就是说不健康的。
Working with orphanages keen for babies for international adoption, Duan and her family scoured the country, buying babies from suppliers.
当时的话，我那个时候零几年的话，我们就是说除了车费啊，车费他们都报了吗？除了车费，他是100-200块钱吧，就是说一天的工资。他一般的话，他就是说。他估计了吗？就是说我们坐车要多少钱啊，奶粉啊衣服啊买的他全部都被报销吗？报了以后他就说再给点工钱给你，他就是准备好的。
After receiving the baby, the orphanage would falsify paperwork, stating where the baby was found, when, and by whom. Then the baby would be put up for foreign adoption, probably by Americans.Since 2000, more than 65,000 Chinese infants have been adopted by American families. It's a huge business.
所谓的助养金，那可能是好比说30,000美金，但是你交30,000美金是一个官方的渠道，你不可能交30,000我就把小朋友送给你了。我会私底下说啊，这个小朋友我养了2年，每年的话将近10万块钱，你私底下还会我不给你开任何的收据的，你还给补偿我这一点。而美国家庭呢，其实他也知道这个比较灰暗的地带，他为了成功收养一个中国小朋友呢，所以他会带大笔的现金到中国来，所以福利院就是又变成涉外收养，又变成他一个牟利的一个方式，所以就加剧了这种现象。
Baby trafficking was at its most lucrative in the early 2000s, but the authorities started to take action. In 2002, trafficker Duan Zilin visited her regular supplier.Together with her mother and sister, she purchased 6 baby girls for $20 each. Carrying them in a cardboard box, she boarded the train for home. It was on the train that the babies were discovered by the police. Duan and her family were arrested, but escaped serious charges. Upon their release a month later, Duan and her family continued trafficking babies.For the years, their reputation soared. More and more people approached them with trafficking opportunities, and their business boomed. In 2005, when the family was delivering 3 babies to an orphanage, the police pounced and arrested them again. This time, their luck had run out.
So, so, 把我们几个就顶了，地脆哟。那些公安呢，反正是抓到我们的。我事后我听他们说100万的。70-80万来给钱呀，我们改不起啊，我们只有去坐牢啊。
In 2006, Duan Zilin and 5 of her family members stood trial. They were sentenced to jail terms ranging from 3 to 15 years. Now released and retired from baby trafficking, Duan still can't quite come to terms with what happened.
毕竟他们是国家单位，是吧？我们只是他雇佣的人去帮他做事，是不是？而且我觉得这个真的好费的，在里面耽误那么长时间，就是说我自己受的都无所谓，你知道吗？那是我小孩，老家里老人啊，小孩呀、啊，你说吧，是不是？真的我无法承受，有时候。
很多就是等于说是重判了。段氏一家就是认为他们是拐卖婴儿的主谋主角，但是其实我觉得他们最主要还是受了福利院的利用，就但是福利院这一块呢，反倒是责罚比较轻，很多都是缓刑。
It's an especially bitter pill to swallow when some culprits in the baby trafficking business are none other than law enforcers themselves. In China.With adoption fees reaching up to $30,000 per baby, a baby trafficking trade has sprung up. Babies are acquired through any means necessary so they can be sold into adoption. With big profits to be made, even family planning officials are in on the act, taking advantage of China's policies.
中国呢，为了控制人口，为了实行所谓以一胎化为主要标志的计划生育政策，它是地方里边是执行的比较严。如果你是没完成指标的话，你的主要行政官员是要被免职，或者是会降职处理的，是很严厉的处罚。民政部门或者是计生部门，他为了收缴那种所谓的社会抚养费，他先把你的小朋友拿在了手里面要挟你，如果你不交的话，他送到福利院里面去。那这是另外一种来源。
The fine in Hunan province, for example, is over $1,500 for every child exceeding the quota. That's more than what the average Chinese farming household earns in a year. In some provinces, the fine is even higher.
如果非法生育第二个孩子，那要征收多少呢？就是在第一次罚款的就算三倍。也就是说，就是一年收入的八倍，就是八年的收入。第二个呢，可能多到上限是24倍。也就是说，我要工作18年，无偿工作8年，才能满足一次罚款。
With large amounts of money at stake, whether from fines or adoption fees, officials prowl neighborhoods looking for unregistered newborns, baby clothes hanging on laundry lines.Or the sound of crying could be enough to give the children away. Even if a baby is an only child, it can be seized if it has been adopted without following proper procedures or been born out of wedlock. Yuan Jiaxi, a village farmer from Hunan province, can testify to the cruelty of losing a child to the agencies.
搞保安，他才在外面呢，捡到了一个女孩子，捡到一个女孩子，他没有老婆，也没有小孩，今年呢，就51岁了。那个时候呢，才2004年的时候捡到的。捡到以后呢，他自己亲自在家里面呢就待了一年的时间，名字叫梅青林。
In adopting a girl.Yuan was in fact alleviating one of the problems of the one-child policy, a large number of abandoned baby girls. Yuan's adopted daughter had found a loving family. But even this was not enough to save her from the hands of the agencies. One day in 2004, Yuan left for work, leaving his one-year-old daughter at home with his elderly mother. Within minutes of him leaving, his mother got a visit.
当时开了一个车，去了4个人，他们是计生办的。
After identifying themselves, the officials snatched Yuan's little girl from the hands of Yuan's mother.
我妈妈这边有那个80多那边有地方。
In Hunan province, when a child is seized, local welfare officials must place notices in local newspapers for 60 days.Appealing for its parents to pay the fine to reclaim the child. But even if they are able to pay, many farmers are illiterate and unable to read the notice.
那些找我找不到，我没读书，我等到哪里到哪里去找？我妈妈她到了计划，你那个儿子没有到60岁，你不可以给月贷。
After 60 days, the baby is labeled an orphan.Its arrival date is recorded as its birthday, its name is changed, and it is put up for adoption. Yuan never got his daughter back.
也不是我一个人嘛，很多人嘛，把那个都分走了，但是个这样，也不是我一样。
By 2005, with kidnappers, hospitals, and even officials getting involved, the Chinese government clamped down. Hundreds of traffickers have been arrested, and tens of thousands of children rescued. At the same time, the conditions for international adoptions of Chinese children have become stricter. Applicants must now meet age, marital status, and income requirements. Approval to adopt a healthy child can now take years.As a result, the number of adoptions by Americans fell from around 8,000 in 2005 to around 2,000 in 2013. These actions seem to be having a positive impact, but it remains to be seen whether baby trafficking in China can really be stamped out once and for all.
看到一个比较乐观的改变，而且说实话是朝着越来越规范、越来越打击力度是越来越强的这么一种好的方向在改变。涉外领养这一块，其实这几年因为很多案例都发生，所以涉外领养这块其实也在逐步规范，所以我觉得应该是在朝着一个好的方向在发展。
Thank you.